Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, your holy apostle, urges us to desire eagerly the greater gifts of faith, hope, and love. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you yourself invite us to remain in your love. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. A marriage, a holy mystery, a symbol, a sacrament of Jesus Christ's love for his church. Hear our prayers for Andrew and Jill. With faith in you, with faith in each other, they pledge their love here today. May their lives always and everywhere bear witness to the reality of that love. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Reading from the book of Genesis. The Lord said, "It is not good for man to be alone. I will make a suitable partner for him." So the Lord God formed me out of the ground, various wild animals and various birds of the air. And he brought them to the man to see what he called them. Whatever the man called them, each one gave its name. The man gave names to all the cattle, all the birds of the air, and all the wild animals. But none proved to be a suitable partner for the man. And so the Lord God cast a deep sleep on the man. And while he was asleep, he took out one of his ribs and closed up its place with flesh. The Lord God then built up into a woman the rib that he had taken from the man. When he brought her to the man said, "This one at last is bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. This one shall be called woman, for out of her man this one has been taken." That is why a man leaves his mother to his wife, and the two of them become one body. The word of the Lord.
Thanks.
Andrew and Jill, I have the privilege of reading to you from God's holy word. And what I'm going to read to you is from 1 Corinthians chapter 13. And a very familiar passage that speaks of love. And as I read these words, the love the Lord is describing is much more than an emotion. It is an action. It is a commitment. It is a decision. And any of us who know you have a great love for one another. I encourage you to listen carefully, to keep your eyes on Jesus, and to follow what he says in his holy word about love. This is the word God. And now I will show you the most excellent way. If I speak in the tongues of men and of angels, but have not love, I am only a resounding gong or a clanging cymbal. If I give all I possess to the poor, if I surrender my body to the flames, but have not love, I gain nothing. For love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It is not rude. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. May God add his blessing to the reading of his holy word.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "As the Father loves me, so I also love you. Remain in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and remain in his love. suitable partner. Andrew and Jill have chosen this particular passage from the book of Genesis for you and me to hear and take to heart at their wedding today, because they believe that it applies to them. They believe with all their hearts and souls that God has made them, from their first meeting and getting to know, to their growing fondness for and coming to cherish each other, partners, suitable partners, soulmates as well as bodymates for one another. Listen to their own words. Here is Andrew writing about his love for Jill. She loves me wholeheartedly. Beautiful, kind, she is always loving, fun, funny. Always thoughtful, honest, caring. She is always there for me. Jill is my sunshine. She is my intended. And here is Jill writing about her love for Andrew. He just makes everything better. When things are bad, and even when they're good, he can still make them even better. Just being near him makes me happy. I love Andrew because he always listens to what I say and always says what I need to hear. He works hard to help anyone in need and sacrifices to make them happy. I know that he would do whatever possible to keep me safe, healthy, and happy. He has such a big heart, and I know that I can trust him completely with mine. Andrew has taught me so much over the past year and a half, but above all, he has taught me the true meaning of love, and that's why I love him the most, because he loves me like no one else could. Aware of their own, aware of each other's limitations and flaws, Jill and Andrew still choose each other as husband and wife because they believe that God has made them that way, suitable partners for each other. I will show you a more excellent way. Remain in my love. Andrew and Jill have chosen these particular passages from 1 Corinthians and from John's Gospel for us to reflect on at their wedding today because they believe that they apply to them. Action to, friendship with, supporting of, and cherishing of one another, to this ceremony, this holy action, this sacrament here today. They believe that Jesus Christ's words, remain in my love, abide in my love, are meant for them as a married Christian couple, as well as individual friends, individual disciples of Jesus. They believe that God's own grace will support and sustain the staying power of their love for each other. Listen again to their own words. Here's Andrew writing about the prospect of his life together with Jill. My hopes for our future are to grow as one, to enjoy every minute together, good and bad. I want us to live our lives and bring up our children like our parents brought us up. I look forward to growing old with Jill. Plan for us to live, love, and be happy together for the rest of our lives. Jill, my sweetheart, I love you. And here is Jill writing about her hopes and dreams for her life together with Andrew. To be as happy together as possible, for as long as possible. To stay home and live comfortably in a house that's not too big or too small. To become the parents we've both been raised by so that we can be surrounded with beautiful, healthy, loving children. And to always miss each other when we're apart and cherish every moment we're together. Jill and Andrew proclaim to one another and to you, their families and friends, their readiness to love one another from here to eternity. They call upon the Lord God to help them give and receive this most excellent way to and from each other, to live the ways of love in bad times as well as in good times. Andrew and Jill, I thank you. I thank you for the freshness and the excitement and the potential of your love. I thank you for being willing to go public with your love, to proclaim the joy that you have found in each other, if not to the whole world,
at least to one another, and to your families and friends here in this church. I thank you for your faith in God, for your belief that it is God who makes you suitable partners for one another, that it is God who shows you the more excellent way, that it is God who urges you to remain in his love, who inspires you to believe that your love for one another, like God's love for us all, never fails. Jill and Andrew, with God's help, may your love outlast us.
These are the hands of your best friend, young and strong and full of love for you, holding yours on your wedding day as you promised to love each other today, tomorrow, and forever. These are the hands that will work alongside yours as together you build your future. These are the hands that will passionately love you and cherish you through the years and with the slightest touch will comfort you like no other. These are the hands that will hold you when fear or grief fills your mind. These are the hands that will countless times wipe the tears from your eyes. Tears of sorrow and tears of joy. These are the hands that will tenderly hold your children. These are the hands that will help you to hold your family as one. These are the hands that will give you strength when you need it. And lastly, these are the hands that even when wrinkled and aged will still be reaching for yours, still giving you the same unspoken tenderness with just a touch. From Andrew to Jill, how do I love you? Let me count the ways. I love you to the depth and breadth, the height my soul can reach, from feeling out of sight for the ends of being and ideal grace. I love thee to the level of every day's most quiet need by sun and candlelight. I love thee freely as men strive for right. I love thee purely as they turn from praise. I love thee with the passion put to use in my old griefs and with my childhood's faith. I love thee with the love I seem to lose with my lost saints. I love thee with the breath, smiles, tears of all my life. And if God choose, I shall have loved thee better. You have declared your consent before the church, and the Lord has
to strengthen your consent, fill you both with his blessings. What God has joined, we must not divide. Lord, bless and consecrate Andrew and Jill and their love for each other. May these rings be a symbol of true faith in each other. Always remind them of their love. In Christ our Lord. Jill, take this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Andrew, take this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Friends,
always follow the example of those holy women whose praises are sung in the scriptures. Father, may her husband put his trust in her and recognize that she is his equal and the heir with him to your life of grace. May you always honor her and love her as Jesus Christ loves his bride, the church. Father, keep them always true to your commandments. Keep them faithful in marriage. Let them be living examples of Christian life. Give them that strength which comes from the gospel, so that they may be witnesses of Christ to others. Bless them with children. Help them to be good parents. May they live to see their children's children, and after a happy old age, grant them fullness of life with all the saints in the kingdom of heaven. All this we ask through Christ our Lord. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace. Peace is my gift to you. Look not on our sin, but on the faith of your church, and grant it the peace and unity of your kingdom, for you live forever and ever. Amen. May the peace of the Lord be always with you. Let us share with one another now some sign of Christ's peace.
In the name of the Father.